was it?
It was tough. You know, it was a good sweat. It's always tough. We only have two guys, a little short-handed, but it was good. I thought it went well. Glad to compete a little bit and try to show my best.
You guys did some one-on-one, right?
Yeah, we did a little bit of one-on-one for the block, for the elbow, stuff like that. We're able to compete a little bit, so yeah.
Did you wind up winning?
He won a lot of them. he's a big guy. He's tough to guard one-on-one. A lot of respect for Josh, really good player.
What was just your initial impressions coming in here, meeting, you know, some of these guys, seeing this facility?
It's a really cool experience. You know, first of all, being in LA, you know, it's a great city, it's fun. And then, yeah, being able to practice in the facility where a lot of really good players practice and, you know, just being able to be on this stage and try to showcase your talents is a really cool experience.
The great Laker Kurt Rambis is around these parts. Do you get a lot of comparisons to
him?
You
know what? I heard that. I heard that today, too. So I'll gladly take that. It's an honor and a pretty cool thing.
Matt, what was the toughest part of your workout?
Oh, the toughest part was probably just all the moves we did. They like to finish a lot of their things. So it's a jump hook, grab the ball, then dunk it. And you're doing that back to back to back with, you know, one guy going in between you. Became pretty fatigued. So,
what's your approach going up against a guy that big?
Trying to contain him as much as possible. I mean, he gets his position really easily. So if you're trying to not let him catch it close to the hoop, it's really hard not to. So you try to contain him as much as you can and make him finish over you.
What part of your game will translate best to the NBA?
I think my ability just to play hard. Whenever I'm on the court, I play my hardest. And, you know, if I could be a big body that clogs up the paint or gets in people's way, you know, I'm never going to be the guy jumping up and blocking anyone's shot like that. But if I could take up space and be a guy who could also pass out of the post, too, I think I'll be able to spread the court a lot when I catch the ball in the post. People look at me, dig down, whatever, and able to kick it out.
Is there a player current or past that you sort of pattern your game or emulate your game after when you study tape?
I think Zach Randolph. He's a guy who's sort of similar in my stature. You know, he's athletic, but he's not the most athletic. I think he has a pretty good mid-range shot, is able to pass the ball. So I think I try to watch a lot of film about him and bottle myself after him.
You seem to have good footwork on offense. We saw in the NCAA tournament, Byron's a defensive-minded coach. What's your biggest strengths defensively?
Defensively, I think I'm in the spot where I'm supposed to be. So when I learned a defensive scheme, you know, at Xavier, we had a pack line defense where we stay within the three-point line. And when I know where I'm supposed to be, I'm always there. So I think when I get a defensive scheme, I'm able to, you know, be the right spot at the right time.
You walk in and you see the trophies, you see the iconic Laker jerseys on the wall. Did you give much thought to what it would be like to play with the Kobe Bryant?
Oh, yeah. You know, after you figure out every workout you're getting, you can always dream about, you know, being part of that team or living in that city or, you know, just the stuff that people have gone through in the past. And, yeah, it's something where it'd be such a blessing. It'd be a great thing for me just to be able to, you know, if I'm the 15th guy on a team and I'm able to cheer people on, work my butt off in practice, do whatever, you know, I'm realistic in knowing that I'm not a guy that's going to be getting a lot of playing time, if any playing time, if making a team. So for me, it's, you know, I want to play my hardest and be able to help a team however I can.